Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. This is Lora with Stitching with Lora. How's everybody doing? I hope everyone is having a great Tuesday. Well, today is Flosstube Day, so I have my cup today for January, and it just kind of says it all. It is frigid here today. And today is my Flosstube Day. So, it is my 211th floss tube. It is January 16th, 2024. Yeah, and we have jasmine green tea. Oh, yeah. It's just, I don't even want to think about going to work. Last night was freezing. It was 30 degrees when I went to work. And by 5-6 o'clock, it went from that to 5, and when I left it was 1, felt like -10. I don't know what it got the rest of the night. I didn't care. I was done. I went to the grocery store because I had to pick up something to eat. Yeah, that was a big... Yeah, right. Let's just get it and go home. Yeah, because I was starving, and so I bought myself a steak. I figured I earned it this week. It's just been cold, a little bit warmer. Cold, really, a little bit warmer. I'm done, people. I'm ready for it to be summer. Yeah, let's go to summer. So, what did I work on last week? Well, you know, contrary to popular belief, I did work on a couple things. And it started out weird. By Thursday, I didn't want to do any stitching up to that point. I was either too tired or I hadn't slept well or this or that. And I just never found the time. So, yeah. But we got it together long enough to do a video for every day that we had last week, so yeah. So we had 5 reviews. Amazing. I don't see where. Got in a few things. I didn't get any mail on Saturday or Monday. So yeah. And we started 4 things. I'm listening to what the cat's doing. I can hear her clicking on the... Because floors, wood floors. Yeah, I don't know. She's kind of... She's not giving me the evil eye. She's just lurking. But not close. Oh, heck no. She's halfway down the hall there somewhere. But I can hear her clicking. One day, she may be right here. But I wouldn't hold my breath. Yeah. There she goes again. So, anyway, so what did I start? Well, we'll just... Oops. I got all my blankets shoved over here, so yeah, to get them out of my freeway. I have the heater blowing directly on me. I have one of those little, I don't know what you'd call it, movable, portable heaters, so it's blowing on me. Oh heck, we're just gonna take this all out of here because everything is totally backwards. Okay, one of the first, not one in any particular order, so don't get excited, is these beautiful houses, and I never got back to them. I'm not sure what day that I did those. Hang on. Is that yesterday? Oh, cow. Not yesterday, it was Sunday. Sorry. But yeah, isn't that pretty? I just love it. I really do, but my mind was occupied elsewhere. So the only part that we got done, let me move that green thread a minute, is up, like on that, what do you call those things? Wooden shutters, and then just that line of the roof line up there. Yeah, that's it. I know. Should have been more, but you'll see. where most of my brain was occupied. Yeah. Let me tell you. I don't know, maybe she's got a bug or something. Not that she's sick. She might have a spider or something that she's moving around here and there. All right. And we started this one on the 12th. What was that? The Thursday, Friday. Friday night. Sorry for the crinkle. This beautiful, beautiful vase. Oh, it's just gorgeous. Yeah, it's going to be right down here in this pile. So that all I got to do is reach it. Oh gosh, did I put that? Okay, I guess I did. Some days I do things and I just don't know when or where. I'm trying, hang on. I'm trying to anchor my needle there for a second. So, the only things that I got done were here, here, and here. I did start on the second color of those flowers. So, yeah, not much. Some weeks are like this. So, another one that'll go down there. And the other start that I had, this came from Fan Cells. And this is what I mostly worked on. It's on the 13th. Hang on. Come on. Please. So this, I started it on Saturday. I can get my hair. Can you tell there's just a little static? It just feels like it's here, there, and everywhere. It's just being that way today. Oh, of course you're stuck. Is this one? I just love this. And you can tell. Hang in there. It is 85 by 102 centimeters, that is. So, let me get to the bottom. So, as you know, we started in the bottom corner. And I got that much done of that little walkway thing that goes through there. And then I decided, you know, I really need to do something else. Let me see if I can get a hold of it. So I stitched the entire top of the pagoda almost. I think there's one more symbol right there. I couldn't get it done before I started work. So isn't that beautiful? I just love it. And, of course, I'm not going to do the back stitching until I'm done. Because you can see how crunched up I've had this material. And all this writing is back stitching. So, all that and the top of the pagoda will not be done until, you know, I'm done with the whole thing. But, yeah, I thought I made some dang good progress on that. Yep, and it was real easy to stitch. I mean, I just kept changing colors, kept changing colors. And I would just get out enough for that area, and it worked out fine. So I'm just going to work a section at a time. So I'll finish that top bottom. You have the roof, and then there's that part in there. So I'll finish that, and then I'll go on to the next, what, 2-inch section or whatever it is, and just work that and just work my way down. We'll see how that all goes. But I'm really absolutely loving it, and I'm so glad that I got it because it's one of the easiest ones I've had in a long time to stitch. All right. This came from Colorful DIY, making sure it's right side up. It's the Colorful Carp. And that was earlier in the week. So, I started, as you know, on the top. This is, like, his mouth is right there. So, it'll come back, and then its eye is right in there somewhere. So, I got that much done with the black. And then, went this way, and started working on leaves and flowers and stuff. yeah, I really like this one too. It's another, just ditch the area and just keep moving. There's nothing hard about it. It's very nice and very easy to see the symbols. Now, on that big one, I will say, you know how I'm always saying, I never use the paper pattern. Hold the presses, because I've used that paper pattern in the past 2 or 3 days more than I've ever used any paper pattern. Just because I just want to make sure that I'm putting in the right color. Hopefully that makes sense. Other ones I've not had any questions about, you know. But this one, yeah, let's just check that out. Yeah. And another one that I worked on, this is from GBFKE, and it's the birdhouses. I'm trying. There we go. It is so pretty. I just love all them colors. I don't know. That's another one. Backstitching, I'll have to wait till the end. And we just are working. I did work on a little bit of the leaves that are down in here. And then I started, before I did the video, just to put in those yellow flowers. Those, where are they? Laser. Black-eyed Susans. I couldn't think what they were called. Right there on that side of that birdhouse. So I started doing that, and I thought, well, that's not a big enough area to use for the video. So that's why y'all got that other color that I worked with. Yes, very nice. Like it too. I like them all. That's half the problem. If I could just put 10 stitches into each one and just keep rotating, 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 it'd take me 40 lifetimes to finish them all. And the last one that I, not the last one that I did stitch, but the last one that I have right here, hold on, we have an issue, is New Orleans. Love it. So we were working up here in this awning thing, and the red that goes all the way across there. I think I was using 498, if I'm not mistaken. I know my friend Jill, who's on YouTube as well, she's working on this, I believe. So, yeah. But we got that red in, and then of course I had to get out the green because I wanted to see the second color in of green into that. So, yeah. And I was going to look for London, and because she had her London one out. Maybe she's only working on London. I don't know. I can't remember. I'm pretty sure she's doing New Orleans too. But that is everything that I stitched this week. For getting... Oh, I set my foot in one position and then I tried to move it. And I think it's broke. Yeah, it's close to broke. Anyway, that's all I stitched on this week. I just feel like I got a late start on stitching, and then all I wanted to do was stitch on that great big one. I just stitched it. My needle was on fire for like, what is that, 2.5 days? I couldn't quit. I barely wanted to go to bed, but it was 2 o'clock in the morning. I had to go to bed, you know. So, yeah. So, I have no idea, but I will be continuing working on that big one, because I love it, and I like that it's in sections. It's not, I haven't run into any confetti yet, so it's very easy to stitch. I just want to make sure the symbols are right, because especially when you have, what was it, 60, maybe 70 colors or something, there's going to be, like, there is a, for example, there is a half blue square. Yeah, it's cut in half. So blue is at one corner for this one, and then in another corner for a different color. So I just wanted to make sure that everything was right side up, you know, not upside down. Because that can happen to me. It happens all the time, especially. So, and I've been trying to pick symbols that aren't set up that way. Does that make sense? Like a red symbol or a purple symbol. But now we have blue, turquoise, and probably a dark blue. It's like, okay, just keep going across, keep going across. And I'm checking it every third color. You know, I mean, just to make sure I'm doing the right color. So, other than that, guys, I think that's going to be about it for this week. I'm sorry there wasn't a whole bunch. I feel like I did nothing except for stitch on that. And you know me, I am not a monogamous stitcher. Yeah. All right, guys. Well, thank you for joining me. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe and please hit the bell. That way you'll know when my next video comes out. Stay safe. Stay healthy. We'll see you next time. God bless. Bye-bye. Keep stitching.